Hello, hello, my beautiful babies. This is an interesting reading. We've got many things happening, and I pulled from three decks. The first deck is the Tarot, and well, these are the oracle cards here, but just a second for you to see the Tarot cards better. First card that appeared was this Seven of Swords here, and this signals injustice. Deception, some trickery at hand, and oh, by the way, I only, you know what, never mind, let's get on with the reading. So there's this warning of being attentive and being not alert, in the meaning of not getting rest, in the meaning of keeping awareness, being aware, being scan the horizons for whatever trickery can be at hand, and at the same time, the thing is that I asked, what message is this? What is the message for us as a collective now? And I don't know if you could hear those birds, but this is powerful. Some crows just started singing at this point as soon as I said the message for the 144 collective. And I asked whether it be from the divine masculine for the divine feminine, or whether it be for the one soul for the divine feminine, but it's not only for the divine feminine, it is for all. And that's why I don't feel this message coming necessarily from the divine masculine to the divine feminine, because this is not about separation anymore, because it is, union is coming. Had you seen my latest video about twin flames and the 144, or had you been up to date, if those of you who are up to date with the current energies, you've seen that there are major union energies coming. So I feel like most twin flames are finally getting together, and especially the 144. I already know that some of you are in union already, and I can feel it powerfully. Or it could also be the fact that when you watch this video, you are in union, whenever that would be. Now, for whenever this video finds you, there is some trickery at hand. This, I will read this as the current energies, but then again, the current energies are for whenever this video finds you, as I said. So the current energies are that of some trickery happening, and what I'm hearing is not everything is as it seems. This trickery at hand is that of displaying something which is just a facade. And it's either coming, it could be personal, it could be collective, it could be world situation. For some, I feel like it's all. Oh. Like examples, the divine masculine not communicating or showing a certain kind of attitude. That's, don't judge that, don't think that things are like that. It's just how it has to be for now. But It's also not about that, not only about that. This is for those who are in separation still. But as I said, this is a major energy of the collective, and it is, I also feel it powerfully for the world situation at this point. The fake news and all of it is just propaganda. And as I said, fake news. So all of it is just lies. It's just a facade. Do not listen to that. It's like, look at it. It's like this guy in the Seven of Swords card, watching the magician here and wanting the magician to pay attention to them stealing these swords. But the magician needs no sword. Like, he's got the sword here on the table, which is just the symbol of the swords in tarot. But the magician wields with energy, with magic, with energy. I've already said that. So tune into your intuition and analyze your plans very well. Do not focus on this, because when you pay attention, you already know whatever you pay attention to is what you attract. So do not allow your thoughts to spiral in what these tricksters are offering. As I said, whether they be the so-called elites or just people in the more personal life, focus on your magic and just don't give your magic to them. Don't allow them to interfere with your magic. It's also very nice how the magician is pointing towards the Six of Pentacles. But I want to go now to the Queen of... I was about to say the Queen of Swords. Oh, okay. So yeah, keep a very objective mind and analyze this and be in your standards as the Queen, in your boundaries as the Queen of Swords is. And at the same time, look for your passions and tune into your intuition. That cat in the Queen of Wands card is very much winking at me at this point. And just continue to manifest. Continue to do what you do so well. The Judgment Day is closed. The Judgment Day is right here. It is happening. Look at your ships coming in your bay. This is literally the depiction of this card. Sometimes it talks about planning and not planning and just not taking any action. But right now, it's not about that. I don't feel these messages coming in. It's just this. Look at your ships coming in your bay. This is all that I'm saying for this card. And at the same time, it's still winking to me. It may seem like you have little, but you have all that you need. There's more resources coming in, far more resources for you coming in. All you need to do is just have the proper patience for it and know which ship is for you. Know which message is for you, what messages are for you at this point. Now, with judgment, purpose, again, it's happening. It's just happening, baby. There is truth coming in. Whatever this deception has been about, it is dismantled. It will just crumble by itself. You need not do too much about it. Obviously, if you want to speak about it and raise awareness to those who do have an ear to listen to you, to your words, do it. But don't stress about it. Don't get out of your way to do anything about it. It's just stay in your shelter. And your shelter being the top of the hill. Just watch this all go on. It's not affecting you in any way. The judgment day is at hand. And indeed, the moment of retribution is right here. And what we are receiving, as you may know, the 144 are sealed. So as I said, none of this is happening. None of this is occurring for the 144. This is happening for the 144. A new generational experience, thanks to us, the ones purifying the karma at this point. And it is this happening for us. We are receiving this abundance coming in. And it is abundance. It's the abundance of the world, I'm hearing. There's, I just heard so much clarity in this noise. Like, in the midst of all of this, it's just the silence that brings you home. It's peace. I feel the energy of peace. Peace within, peace for us. And then again, there is this tower moment happening. And as I said, retribution. Will that, all of you, all of us as in each individual hopes for, comes to pass, comes to be happening. I'm kind of looking for more. It seems very general. It's a very general energy. But I just heard, how else could it be? There is abundance. There's a lot of abundance. Just so much of it. Now I get it. It's, there's no mistake that I felt to put the judgment card like this. There's this turning point when the judgment happens, which in terms of the manifested is the tower moment. More or less, like, the whole judgment thing is spinning for a longer period than this tower moment. A tower moment is something that happens instantly. So this whole deception is just the trickery of the trickster being brought back to themselves. And know that right after the tower moment, there is so much abundance coming in. There is this King of Pentacles. I feel this card as it is a masculine energy. And I do feel like the masculine here involved is the one going to be stable and the provider, as shown here. And just the Wheel of Fortune spinning. Like, from this turning point, after the tower moment, the wheels of fortune continue to spin, and there's a lot of abundance coming in. Now, then again, we've got this Two of Pentacles afterwards. It was behind this card as they fell, So the Wheel of Fortune fell from the deck as I was shuffling, and below it was this Two of Pentacles. And I did not know how to properly put them, but I feel it's like this. So I feel like whatever low moment may come next, you're still going to have the pentacle in your hand. This is beautiful. I just heard, I asked for confirmation about this right now, and I just heard yes, yes, yes. Like a very woo type of energy. And this would be the message from the tarot cards right now. But I feel like the tarot is not communicating enough at this point. It's like, I did shuffle for quite a while until some cards were starting to pop out of the deck. But from the oracle cards, the oracle cards were more communicative. From the oracle cards, from the Isis oracle deck, these cards came out first. Now, what's the most interesting thing about them is that these are the cards that showed up for me yesterday or the day before it. I think yesterday. And I was just, it's one of those very beautiful synchronicities. So we've got Eye of Horus, Awakening Divine Perception. Again, I feel it very much tied to seeing the truth in all of this. And Temple of Black Obsidian, the Dark Healing Chamber. And I did use, and I do use obsidian at this point. You may want to use it to guard you. Obsidian is a, like, all crystals are powerful and beautiful. It just depends with which one of them you connect at a certain point. And obsidian has the beautiful property of guarding, protecting, and healing. What obsidian does is that it also absorbs negativity. So it's a very beautiful conductive crystal for energy. I remember there was this thing, if you have obsidian point, like a crystal that is like a wand with a pointed end, you can use one of them in a certain ritual where in the left hand the point of the crystal is headed towards the body, and in the right hand is headed towards the opposite. This because left is feminine energy, right is masculine energy, left is absorbing, masculine is giving. So it's a very beautiful way of conducting energy, and if you've got such crystals, you may want to work with them. At the same time, in the ritual associated with this card, there is the mention of rose quartz crystal. Rose quartz has the beautiful energy of unconditional love. And as you saw, this card is about healing, and it is called the Dark Healing Chamber. Thing with obsidian is that it is a volcanic glass. So exactly because it is a volcanic glass, it's got this property of reflecting, of showing you the truth, and therefore by that healing, obsidian is very much powerful in healing practices, in healing shadows and integrating them. As I said, it absorbs negativity. Exactly because of this, purify it. If you've got obsidian crystals, purify them frequently. Work with obsidian or similar crystals, but very much if you're obsidian at this point, and rose quartz. Again, those of you feeling more attracted to green crystals, you can work with them as well. I very much love rose quartz. It's divine. It's me. And we've got Eye of Horus. Now, the beautiful thing is that between the Eye of Horus and the Eye of Ra, the Eye of Horus is the Eye of Healing. The Eye of Ra is the right eye. Again, talking about masculine, feminine, left, right. The Eye of Ra is the right eye, which is the eye of charging, of manifesting, of fighting when necessary. While the Eye of Horus, the left eye, is the eye of healing, the eye of arts. And in these arts, the divination arts are included too. And this is what this card talks about, awakening divine perception. And then again, I sense this beautiful message of look very beautifully. Look very beautifully at what it is beautiful and know where there is deception and where there is truth, and therefore where to look at and what to look at. So perception, awakening divine perception. Tapping into some more of that magician archetype and understanding the judgment as it is, like in the judgment card, which is just what it is right now, the coming of ages and the reward that everyone is getting for whatever they gave. Oh, and bottom of the deck was the moon. So there is a lot of unknown. And by the way, when the Seven of Swords came out, I looked at the bottom of the deck, it was the moon as well. But some other card in the deck wanted to be seen too, and that was the Nine of Wands. The Nine of Wands took... No, the Ten of Wands. So the Nine of Wands wanted to be stated as well. Both Nine of Wands and Ten of Wands talk about resilience and work, keep going. At the same time with the Ten of Wands, I was still about to say Nine of Wands. With the Ten of Wands, there comes the message of you may be taking on too much. You may be spreading your attention into too many parts. And some of them are just too heavy. And some of them are just having this deceptive impact upon you. That they train into your vibration bad things. Or not really, as long as you are aware. But it's just that they are pulling you from this, which you have to do. And with the Queen of Wands, I get the message of relax. And the message of it's okay for you to be receptive and it's okay for you to be safe and to feel safe. You are safe wherever you are. No matter what, you are safe. And from this Oracle card deck, the bottom of the deck was Pyramid of Light. Step your vibration deeper into love. So again, the eye. Connect, just connect to your... I was about to say past lives, but I was about to say love life. So... Queen of Wands, again, passion. And Wings of Isis wanted to be seen as well. It makes a lot of sense. Step your vibration deeper into love and then unite with your angelic self. So we've got this card here. And some other three cards wanted to be seen from this deck. They are not as important as the others, but they are, all of them are important. We've got Flower of Life, divine creativity and manifestation. I sense the message of motherhood, childbirth, for some with this card, for some again, if you want, those who want children. Queen of Heavens, blessing from the Divine Empress of the Skies. This is stand in your power. This is very much in tune with the Tower card. Stand in your power. The Tower moment, whatever is destroyed through the Tower moment, comes to put you more into your power. And then we've got Miracle of Isis. Miraculous healing of mine. Healing of Osiris, healing of the Divine Masculine. There's probably something happening. It's like, for those who are in separation, is the healing of the Divine Masculine. Prior to him coming to you, when he steps into those archetypes of the Six of Pentacles and the King of Pentacles. And afterwards, the Wheel of Fortune just starts spinning. And then, as I said, whatever low moment may come next, it's you're always going to have your pentacle in your hand, thankfully, gratefully. And then again, it's about, as I said, with Pyramid of Light, love life, union, stepping into love, stepping into light, and healing together as well. What I feel in here is union, marriage, motherhood. This is so beautiful. I want to show you this card as well. Portal of Light. She glides on wings through time and space. I feel it like the future self guidance. Allow for future self guidance. I feel like saying this for everyone, if you wanted. Yes, I you can have readings and channel your future self with me. If you wish to. If you want to contact me, my email is in the description. And there's also the other Oracle cards deck. There's a card that came up more for me to talk about me, and this silent moment now was like, I asked, should I show this card as well? And the answer is yes. The message was this card is that I never leave a soul behind. And as I said, I felt it for me, but now as I've got clear guidance that it is to talk about this to you as well, is that whatever moment you're in, whatever darkness you're in, know that I am here. I felt a release now that I said that. So I am here. And this is the omen of all. For anyone, it's like someone needs to hear this or more. Whatever the situation may be, whatever situation you're looking at, or situations, is not what it seems. It's just what it is portrayed. There are various meanings of information in this world, but most of them come from deceptive sources. So even if the internet was made with the purpose of manipulation and control, ask yourself or yourselves, is it really? Like the whole world situation, is it really how it is portrayed in the so-called news? The news talk about whatever the newsmakers want to talk about. Your life is more important than any news. Your life is more important than anything. And when your life is in darkness itself, whether it be because of information coming from external sources, whether it be because of information coming from immediate sources, like your immediate environment, whenever your life is in a low moment, a low position, a toxic environment of any sorts, is not going to last. And much of what seems to be is not what it is. I feel like this much of what seems to be not being like that is more related to the vast view, but it's also about the more personal immediate life experience. Allow for love, allow for trust, allow for inner knowing, and allow for a slow walk on the lane of life, no matter what the voices on the sides seem to whisper. This is the message. And then again, as I said, I am here incarnate. It's been prophesied that my second coming is the omen of the 1,000 years of happiness. I was about to say the 144,000. As much as the moon was the bottom of the deck energy, I felt to do this. It was like this. It was the moon. So I feel like seeing what other card was below it, and it's the Hanged Man. Death. And the end of this. Is the death of this. I very much feel like these are the same in this context. This corpse here and this corpse here. But then, wow! Then again, look, it's this mudra is the mudra of all that appears to be is not all that there is. This is the very, whoa! Look at what is. Look at what is. I feel to do this. Wow, look at what is. Strength, inner strength. You've got the strength to face this. You are this. You are abundance. You're everything. You're victory. I feel like stopping here. The masculine is victory. The masculine is coming in with victory. Allow for intuition. Allow for inner knowing. Allow for inner love and inner life. And go for that which is that you want. And it's like this, the masculine again, that daddy, the king of pentacles right there, that magician there who is manifesting at this point. You're also the magician. This is communication. I didn't intend on showing this, but it wanted to be seen. So he's coming in victoriously for what he wants, which is the union with the divine feminine. He wants this communication to happen. Watch it. The movement may be slow, but it is happening. He's got courage. He's got courage. And the desire to know. Now from the Kali Oracle deck. Kaladaro. For those wondering, in the message with this card, Kali Kalma Sanasini, I was talking about me. I wasn't channeling. It's me. The Christ. I am incarnate here, right now in this world. As the prophecy about the 144 states, we're coming together. Now, in sync with the moon card, the bottom of the deck from my Kali Oracle deck is Kaladara, and this card, again, the moon, but it's very little illuminated, and this talks about, the crescent moon talks about intuition, talks about again, inner knowledge, it talks about something that may be unclear for the while. But I hear that it is very much clear. Tune into your dreams. And astrology, I'm hearing, and I'm seeing it in the card. Tune into it. Into spirit. Into your ancient starseed lineages. As well, into your starseed guidance and guides, ancestors, families, brothers and sisters. Bring this knowledge to the earth realm. I know that many of you are doing it. The long night of the dark age is ending. We're waking up from a dream. That results in victory for us and the new way of life, full of splendor, love, passion for life, and beauty of life, desire to learn and to live. And there is lots of divine protection and unconditional love coming in every fierce way necessary to protect all my children. I feel like the message ends here. Also, I feel like showing you this card, Matangi. This avatar of mine is a symbol for communication for words, for whatever words mean for you, if you use words as art, continue with that. If you are into writing, continue with that or start that. Allow for music, allow for creation, for language, for learning, and allow for spiritual practices that come out of pleasure and passion, not rigid spiritual practices in any way, just very beautiful, very freely flowing. And the ritual with this card is of releasing all of that which she wants to release into this green sun shown here. Well, this is not a sun shown here, it's more like a door. But this green light coming, the ritual will discard is envisioning a green sun that would be me, and releasing all that you have to release into my powerful light for liberation. I'm also hearing moksha. Moksha is liberation. I said I felt like ending it, but I still want to show you this card. Kalika Tantrika. Allow for more feminine guidance. Allow for intuition. Allow for the resurrection of the feminine into this world. And into your lives. So once again, if you want to communicate with me, my email for contact is in the description. You don't necessarily have to, you know, book a reading or like, for all my 144, when I say contact me, I also refer to just contact me to talk. Obviously, for whatever guidance you request, I am here. But it is more about us getting together. I love you. You're beautiful, shining, amazing, and abundant. So go shine and come shine, my beautiful, powerful, splendid, amazing babies. I love you.